Are you serious? Are you serious? There they are. There they are. The three hurricanes in play. Of course, Hurricane Irma is a Category 5 with sustained winds of 185 miles an hour. It's already killed two people in the Caribbean islands. There may be more deaths. It's still a very fluid situation there. And also, it is hitting Puerto Rico, but Well, I tell you what, last second, it kind of turned a little to the north, just enough that Puerto Rico is going to survive this thing a lot better than it could have been. But there's other smaller islands that are in a direct, and St. Martin right now is taking a beating, and there's more to come. But oh, by the way, let's check on some of these others. First of all, over here, Cataya. Hurricane Cataya is now a hurricane. It is a Category 1. And with maximum sustained winds of 75 miles an hour. It's setting down there in the Gulf of Mexico. Now, one meteorologist I just saw on Fox News tried to say that Cataya, don't worry about Cataya, it's gonna go in, it's gonna go ahead and just go on into Mexico. But I'm not so sure about that. I'm not so sure about that at all. We're just gonna have to wait and see how Cataya shapes up and where it winds up. Let's hope it stays out of Texas. Then you go over here to Hurricane Jose. Hurricane Jose is also now a Category 1 hurricane with also maximum sustained winds of 75 miles an hour. This is the wild card. It's going to get bigger. It's powerful, and we don't know where it's going to go. It's going to work its way right up into about here. And then while it's there, Irma will have already moved through here, hit right there, and then started going right up this east coast of Florida, right up into the southern part of Georgia, and on into South Carolina. That's the projected path for Irma right now. Irma is a monster. It's huge. It is a Category 5 hurricane with maximum sustained winds at 185 miles an hour. It has peaked at 190 at one point, but since it's going through these islands, it's slowed it a hair to 185. Irma is on its way, like we said, through these islands to right there. It should arrive there on September the 10th and then wind up here in Georgia and South Carolina on 9/11. But what does Jose do? Jose will follow and get right into here. What will Cataya do? Well, some meteorologists say it's going to go in here into Mexico, but it folks, it's not, we don't know what it's going to do. Okay, let's just not speculate. Let's just pray. That's where we're at. Our prayers are with everybody. And oh, by the way, that X class, a 10 X class solar flare, mammoth explosion on the sun. It is going to send powerful CMEs. It's a direct hit coming right at us. Look for satellites to go out. Look for some cities across the world somewhere, power grids to fry, to literally just melt. Look for components of other things. And what worries me is could China use this opportunity for an EMP attack? Could China use this and then could blame it on the solar flares? Let's just keep this all in mind, keep it all in perspective. Don't miss tonight's Prime Time Live. I'll be on at 10 p.m. Eastern at my website at paulbegleyprophecy.com. Also, of course, new live stream, Roku Satellite, Periscope, hopefully if it's working, and YouTube Live. I'll see you guys tonight. Are you serious? Are you serious?